home preparation for sale. Home preparation in this crazy seller's market? All you need to do is put a sign in the yard. Well, that's what we're talking about today. We're getting started right now. Hi, I'm Angela Lockett. I'm a realtor with Narrative Real Estate. I help people buy and sell homes in the western suburbs of St. Louis. Welcome to my channel. If this is your first time here and you like what you see, consider giving me a like or thumbs up, subscribing to my channel, and hit that little bell icon so that you're notified every time I post a new video. Today we're talking about what you can do to get a buyer to fall in love with your house. Home preparation for sale is really not going to determine whether or not your house sells. In this market, any house will sell. What price will the house sell for? So the goal always in selling a house is to sell the home for as much money as possible in as short a time as possible. And everything that you do to prepare your home for sale is going to have a big impact on achieving those two goals. There's a bonus tip at the end, something you might not have thought of, that is a listing agent's secret weapon. We're talking about home preparation for sale. The preparation begins with the exterior of the house. Make sure that the grass is cut, that there are no dead shrubs, plants, bushes. You want to depersonalize the exterior. So if you have some of these flags or wind chimes or yard ornaments, remove all of that and just make the house streamlined. Power wash if necessary, take down screens, and that will make the windows really pop. Very seldom do most people actually use their front door. A lot of people come in through the garage or some other entrance to the house. So put yourself in the buyer's shoes. While their agent is opening the door, buyers are standing behind the agent, taking in their surroundings. They're looking at the screens, they're looking at the storm door, they're looking at the numbers on the house, looking at the porch. You want all of that to be in the very best condition possible because you only have one opportunity to make a first impression. Major repairs are super important. If there are major repairs that need to be done, you need to just bite the bullet and get them done, because if you don't, your house is going to be seen as a fixer-upper. And if it's seen as a fixer-upper, but it's going to be sold at a fixer-upper price. So get any major repairs done. Along with major repairs, make sure you get any minor repairs done. When a buyer sees something like a torn screen, a loose railing, leaky faucet, what they begin to think is, if this seller has not attended to these minor repairs that I can see, how has the seller managed those big ticket items, those big maintenance items that I can't see? So we don't want to create that level of doubt in the buyer's mind. We are trying to court the buyer every step of the way. Another thing you can do to prepare the house for market is go through and see if there are any needed updates. I'm not saying rip out the kitchen and the master bathroom. However, if the homes that are comparable to yours in your neighborhood are of an age that most of them have had kitchen updates or bathroom updates, then you need to recognize that buyers are going to take that into account. But there may be minor updates that you can do that would not be big ticket items, but would still have a big impact on the desirability of the home. One of those is painting. The majority of buyers prefer light, trendy, neutral paint colors. Another update that is fairly inexpensive is replace light fixtures. You can go to a Home Depot or a Lowe's and find some very current looking, very trendy light fixtures and truly transform a space just by swapping out the light fixture. You also need to go through your home and declutter. It's going through and doing a pretty serious edit of your belongings. If you're already a minimalist, then you're probably good to go, but most of us are not. Most people have a lot of extra pieces of furniture or decorative items that really don't contribute to the attractiveness of the home to a buyer. Only leave those pieces of furniture that communicate the singular purpose of that room. What I mean by that is this. You have a guest room that has somewhere along the line acquired an aquarium and a treadmill and a desk and a second dresser. That's a space that needs to be edited. It could either be a workout room, or it could be an office, or it could be a guest room, but it can't be all three. So remove those extra items so that it's very clear what the function of the space is. It will immediately feel larger. The same is true of closets and storage areas. If you remove half the items, then those spaces are immediately going to seem larger. It's also a good idea to remove any personal family photos and a very personalized collection. You know, that frog collection that you have had since second grade? You might want to pack it up. In terms of removing all of the family photos, yes, there can be exceptions to this. But let me just tell you what happens when a buyer goes into a home that is filled with wall-to-wall of family photos. The buyer is distracted. They begin to wonder, do they know you from somewhere? They're wondering, where did you go on your honeymoon? Honey, do you think that's St. Thomas? After a buyer's agent has taken a couple out and shown them a few homes, you can tell which homes they've made a connection with because they'll say, oh, the home that has the bay window, because they visualize themselves sitting in front of that bay window drinking a cup of coffee. What we want is the buyer to go through your house and be thinking about and making a connection to your house and not be thinking about you. It can't be overstated how important cleaning is in getting your house ready for the market. You need to clean like you've never cleaned before. Take down the screens and get the windows cleaned. Go ahead and power wash the exterior. But of course, beyond all of these external and peripheral issues in terms of cleaning, make sure the house is clean top to bottom. If cleaning is not your thing, that's okay, because there are people who do it for a living. So whether you do it or you hire somebody else to do it, make sure the house is sparkling clean. And the last thing I want you to think about is doing final sniff test. When a buyer comes into your home, they don't want to smell anything. No cooking odors, no evidence of Fido or Fluffy. And now here is our bonus tip. Is one scent that wins a buyer's heart, and that is the scent of fresh paint. A little bit of a secret weapon. The smell of fresh paint is kind of like a new car smell. I wish you all the best in getting your home prepared for market. If you have any questions or comments, go ahead and put those in the comment box down below. I love it when people who've seen my videos reach out. Thanks again for stopping by, and I'll see you on the next one.